Today, we'll figure out things later. Now we're just recording with the phone and we can start again.
Okay, so from the beginning, right? Again. So, hello, my name is Paweł Mogiła and I'm a PhD student at Jagiellonia University. I am also indie game developer and I make games. I created a game called Community Dead, which was released 2 months ago on Steam. And I'm developing a new game, which will be in Godot. And I will show the colliding particles in Godot. So, currently Godot is not supporting the collision with the particles, but there is a very easy way to implement that without ever modifying the engine code, source code. So we have two nodes in the Godot with the particles. So there is CPU particles 2D and the particles 2D, which are on GPU, and the first one is on the CPU. And luckily, this second one on the GPU can be modified, so you can write the custom shader code. So we will use the GPU particles because they can be modified without the modifying the Godot source code. So we in particles 2D we have process material, which can be particles material and the shader material. Particles material is like a fixed shader, which you can mess with the parameters, and the shader material is you can put the custom code in the shader. So we start with the shader material in the particles 2D. But when you are in Godot and you add shader material as a process material, you start with the empty window code. So we don't want that because we just want to add the particles and we want the existing logic to be present there. So the color interpolation over the time, size change over the time. So we need to make it other way. First we start with the particle material, and then in the drop down menu we have convert to the shader material, and that gives us a shader material with the base code we can work on. And so it worked the same way like a particle material, but on the shader, and we can edit that and add the collision code. Okay, so here is the collision theory. So like I'm doing that. So I treat the particles as points. So single vector is a position. And to perform collision, we just need two things. Whether the particles is inside the collision object, that's one. And the second one is a collision normal. Collision normal is a vector outside the collision object. So outside vector, how to escape from the collision object. So here is the graphical representation. So the particle is flying. The vector is, the arrow is a velocity vector. So nothing happens, we don't have collision. Now we have collision, and we need to calculate the normal, and we need to calculate new velocity. So the that cyan color was the old velocity, and now we just reflecting the old velocity with the normal. And we have new velocity, and that's all. We change the velocity, and it fly the other direction. It bounces from the collision object. So, in my case, I have a collision object as a texture, because a texture is a very easy way to put into the shader. Right now, I'm using very big one, 8K by 8K texture, and I treat it like that. So, if the alpha is zero, there is no collision. So, if the picture is transparent, there is no collision, and if not, then I have collision. So here is an implementation of these two functions. So first function is the is pixel solid, so it checks if we have collision at the specified point. And the second function is a collision normal, which gives us a normal at the specified point. So first function is very easy, is just sampling the texture at the point we want to know. And if it returns the alpha channel, just like that. And the collision normal is a little bit more complicated, but not much. It's just two for loops. And we are adding the vectors from this center on this sampling to the sampled vector. I will show you maybe on the example. So that's how we calculate the collision normal. So we have a sampler range, like here is sampler range from -3 to the +3. And we are sampling these pixels. And if the pixel is solid, we just add the vector from the center to the pixel. And we sum up all together. Actually, there are negative of the vector. And we have collision normal, which is not very accurate, but it works. Then we need to plug this function into the particles update code. So after the interpolation of the color, of the sizes, and graphical stuff that happens in the particles, we can put the collision code. And we just check if in the position of the particle there is a solid geometry. So transfer free is a collision particle position. And if the collision is present, then we can just get the collision normal at this place, normalize it, and project to bounce off the collision object. One hacky thing I have here is that at the end I'm just adding the collision normal to the position to escape just a little bit from the collision object. It's not 100% accurate and correct physics, but it works for me, so I'm using that. And I will show you now how it works. Okay, so particles are visible for you?
Yeah.
I can change, okay. So here is the terrain. So the brownish color is the terrain, and the particles are bouncing from the terrain. And what is more, I can modify the terrain because this is a simple texture, right? So I can put the pixel or remove the pixels, and this is what we get for free, that particles shader has updated texture. So I can make a tunnel, for example, and the particles are going to the tunnel. And right now I have about 12,000 particles on 2020. Yeah, if particle gets trapped, then its velocity is set to zero. That's what I wanted. But we can increase that number of the particles. The maximum that I can get here is about 2 million. Okay, so yeah, so 2 million particles right now. So it looks like water now, because there is no empty space almost.
Yeah.
Looks very cool.
And we can make a tunnels or something like that. Okay. So that's the particle collision. And now we have, I have another problem to present. The bonus problem is the that what if we would like to interact with the particle? Because right now it's just the graphical representation, right? So if I go with the player to, if player collides with the particle, I can fade the particle out to make an animation like it's picked up, but there is no feedback to the CPU, because if I would like to, let's say that the particles are coins or something you need to grab, and you would like to, for example, update the inventory count number or something like that, and there is no easy way to do that. The obvious solution would be, from the CPU to the CPU to the GPU is easy. Just send the player position, and you can check if the each particle is near the player, and then animate like is taken. But the other way is not so trivial, because there is lot of data from the particles, more than 1 million, like you saw, and the obvious way to do that is to, right now we are talking about modifying the Godot source code. We can do glmat buffer range to get the particular data, and there is also the position. So you can do that, but you still have to iterate over the particles to check if the particle is near the player. And then if the particle is near the player, you just add one coin because it's collected like so. But it's slow, because this function is slow, and you still have to iterate over the data on the CPU. And this is also slow, because you have for loop for about 1 million particles and check the distance to the particle from the player. But I found another hacky solution, and here it is. So the tricky solution is when the shader detects that particle is near the player, because we can do that in the shader, I set the particle color to almost transparent, like black, very little above the black, so alpha to 1/255, so it's visible but it's almost black, and I'm moving the particle to the magic place outside the map. For me, it's a position -10,000, -10,000, where nothing's happened. No, I have no entities in that position, and I'm doing that just for one frame, just for the one frame, and this magic place is rendered to the texture. And the rendered texture is very small. It can be 1 pixel by 1 pixel. And I'm rendering this texture each frame. And then I can send that 1 pixel or 4 pixel, like I written here, back to the CPU. And this is fast. You just make the standard Godot function get pixel on the texture. And if the color of the pixel is black, then I know that no particle is in that place. So there is no collision, so the player didn't collide with the particle. And if the color is not black, I need just check the intensity of that color. So if the color is 1/255, then I know I collided with the one particle. And if we, in one frame, it's possible that we collided with the more than one particle, the brightness of the color in that place increases. And after that, I need to delete that particle or simply make the color of it the transparent, so so it wasn't counted again. So I shall regain that method. It's possible to see here. So here is a counter. You can see the number of particles I have collected, and if I know not colliding with the particles, it stays still. And right now I'm collecting, so it increases. And here you can see the texture. This 2 pixel by 2 pixel texture, which is of course scaled up, and you may see that it's black, but it's not. It's some grayish dark color there. But if I go to the more crowded place with the more particles, right now you can see that it's gray, and I'm reading that color I'm adding that to the player's inventory, for example. So the particles could be collectables, or maybe you might have to know if you collided with the particles to decrease the player life or something like that. Yeah, so that's all I would like to say about that. Thank you for your attention, and if you want to see more of that, what's come from this technology and this destructive terrain, you can follow me on Facebook, on Twitter, and that's all. Thanks.
Did you try this on mobile GPUs?
No. I don't know how simple built-in particle 2D works on the mobile, but the change to the shader code are not so big. I'm sampling the texture a lot, because for one collision point, I'm sampling about 36 pixels, so it might be a bottleneck there, but no, I didn't try that. I didn't try that. I was thinking about that, but I don't know how to do that, because the easy way is to have that data in the texture. So for the one collision object is easy, but if you would like to have particles colliding with each other, then I don't know. Maybe you should render that to texture and have dots over the texture, and then check out with that texture, but I didn't try that.
So with two different kind of particles, like there was a game called Wicked War where you had to these kind of particles battle with two colors or something.
Okay, what's the name of the game? Of this game? Okay, I didn't know about this
That's
game.
That's the game I was talking about before.
The old one.
Okay. Yeah, great thing.
Cool.
Yeah.
So we want now to have instruction back from the player to the particles, like the next event. We can just vary the word with particles and then to the player. Because yes, what's that to say?
Sorry, I don't hear.
Are the particles removed from the scene when they are touching the player, or was it just the same score?
So we are asking about this magic place where I'm moving the particles?
Yeah, because you gave examples of coins.
Yes, yes.
In this game, I would expect coins to disappear.
It's in the shader. There is a check. Because I have player position as a uniform, So if the particle is near the player, so less than 10 pixels, I can just make the color of the particle alpha to zero, and it disappears. It's still on the GPU, but you can see them, because, and you count just on the CPU. So it's still calculated, but it's not visible to the player.
Is there a way to just get rid of it, or we just recycle it?
Again, please?
Is there a way to get rid of it, or just recycle it?
I don't know. You could probably decrease the number of particles and swap the data to the beginning, but I didn't do that. That works well for me, so I didn't try to decrease the buffer. Because that would probably, if we could, if you use the basic basic built-in particle 2D, it will destroy the whole buffer probably. But you can also, you can change that in the source, but I didn't try that. Yes?
Have you tried it on integrated views?
No. Yeah, but if the built-in particles 2D work well, then this would perform, I think, I don't know, maybe twice slower, I would say. Maybe something like that. Because I didn't try the... I tried the built-in particles, and I, on this laptop I get about... I tried 100 million, and it was choppy. So but this was smooth with the 2 million. Yeah? So I don't know. So this is.
Thank you very much.
Okay. Thank you.